I'm saying,
is this gonna be video?
You're vlogging.
Hey, what's up, you guys? My name's Allie, and welcome to my channel. Sorry about the lighting. It's really nice out today. I am currently parking, waiting for my mom because we're going to go do some antique shopping today. I live in a town. I'm like on the outskirts of the uptown, but their uptown area is super cute. I'll try to film a little bit without being too obvious. I don't know. People don't film here in Columbus, so I'm always like nervous to film in public. But anyway, I am specifically looking for some things to put on a gallery wall. So if you've been following my vlogs for the last couple months or so, you know that we've done a ton of home renovation in our house. In the one wall that I keep saying we're going to do, the brick wall, we haven't done it yet, but I want to do a gallery wall up on there behind our couch. I think that'll be like really cool with a lot of like vintage antique pieces. So that's what I'm looking for today. We don't have the brick wall done, but I'm still looking because why not? But that is the mindset of today. That's what I'm looking for, stuff for the wall. And it is just going to be a nice, fun afternoon. It's been a stressful week. So, solution, go thrifting. Say hello.
What?
Say hello.
Hello.
Let us journey now to Summerfield, nestling like a pearl in the golden setting of the autumn countryside. Trees. Trees are one of the loveliest features of this lovely little town. Shimmering poplars, stately elms, giant maples lining the quiet streets. And as they turn from crimson to gold, the leaves come drifting down. And as the leaves come drifting, in each front yard we find a small boy raking. Ah, the simple joys of youth, the rich reward of living close to nature. For as he reaps the golden harvest, raking the leaves into orderly piles, ever and anon comes the playful wind and scatters them.
Where's mommy? Go find her. Where is she, Bubba?
He said, you've hid there before. First time I hid there, it took him a long time.
You found me.
Okay.
So there'd be no doubt. Call on the North Wind to come on out. Then cupped his hand so proudly to shout, la-di-da, la-di-da, tis autumn. The trees say they're tired, they've borne too much fruit, charmed all the wayside.
Look at all those chickens!
They don't give a hoot. La-di-da-di-da-di-da, tis autumn.
Hello there.
To chirp about the weather. La-da-di-da-da-di-da. After making their decision in birdie-like precision, turned about and made a beeline to the south. My holding you close really is no crime. Ask the birds, ask the trees, and old Father Time. It's just to hell. The mercury climb, la-di-da.
One day you turn around and it's summer. Next day you turn around and it's fall. And the springs and the winters of a lifetime, whatever happened to them all? As a man.
Oh, hello there. It's the next day. I'm in a different outfit. I'll actually insert a clip of my outfit today because I tried. Because today is fun. We're going, and by we, I mean me and my mom and dad, are going on a little adventure today. We're going about an hour away to this really cute marketplace that has kind of an antique mall, but like way nicer than the antique mall that my mom and I went to yesterday. And they have like a place where you can get like homemade jam and stuff like that, just like a fall market. And I really haven't done any kind of like fall activities this year at all, which is depressing. So this will be a really nice day. And if you've lost track or are confused, this is the fifth spot that we're going to. My mom and I only intended on going to one like antique store yesterday, but we ended up going to four. And I got everything I wanted for the gallery wall. I really went into it just being like, I don't know what I'm gonna get, but I found some stuff to make a complete gallery wall. And once I get home today, I will do a little haul for you guys and show you what I got. I of course ended up getting some other stuff too that was not intended for the gallery wall, but that's okay because we did get some good deals and some cute stuff. So today I'm going to try really hard not to buy anything, and actually I don't even have my debit card because Ryan can't find his wallet, so he had to borrow my debit card. So I will not be buying anything today. It'll just be for fun, so I will get some fun clips for you guys, and I will check in with you guys later to do a little haul.
Of my golden warm September of my year. Them to the end of a faded summer love, when an early autumn walks the land and chills the breeze and touches with her hand the summer tree. Perhaps you'll understand what memories I owe. There's a dance all shuttered down a winding country lane, all russet brown.
All right, so it is the next day, the third day of this whole antique Thrift-a-Palooza, whatever this has become. We started out intending to go to one thrift store, one antique store, and we ended up going to six. So I got a lot of stuff. I did not intend to get as much stuff as I got, but I have a purpose for everything I got, and that's what matters, right? I will quickly get through everything I got for you guys because I'm sure you're curious. What's a video without a haul? But I will do it quickly because I got a lot of stuff. The first store that we went to was an antique store, and I got three things for my gallery wall. The first is this, I don't even know what you call it. These are like very in right now, but I do really like the style of them. It kind of just has like an antique look. I don't know that this one actually is antique itself. They had a lot of them, but I thought it was really cool. It'll be a nice addition to the wall. And then also from that store, I got two antique license plates. So this one is a 1939 plate from Pennsylvania. And if you guys don't know by now, I am from Pennsylvania. My husband is from Pennsylvania. So just a cool homage to our second home, really. And then the other license plate is an Ohio plate, and it is from 1932. So these plates will both go on that gallery wall. Then the second store that we went to, it was kind of like an antique mall, they call it, where it's like a big building and there's lots of different vendors within that building. I actually didn't end up getting anything from that shop. It was kind of a bunch of junk, to be honest. It wasn't that great. Some of the sillier things that you may have seen in this video were probably from that shop. It was fun to walk through, but I didn't end up getting anything from there. The third place we went to was good old Goodwill, and you know I found some stuff. So I didn't actually find anything for the gallery wall, which is what I went in there for, and I told myself I wasn't gonna look at clothes, but of course I did, and I did get some good stuff. The first thing I got was this little Ann Taylor cardigan. I really like this one because I'm not actually a huge fan of cardigans on myself, but I like that this is like a slightly crop fit, and I thought that this would look really cute with some high-waisted jeans. I also got this pair of like real wide leg, like kind of linen-y type jeans. I was actually just eyeing up a pair of Madewell jeans that are very similar cut to this on Madewell because the wide leg jean trend is kind of really back in style. But I'm glad I ended up getting these from the thrift store because I didn't want to pay a bunch of money if I don't really like the look on me. So I thought this was a good starter pair, and yeah, if I like the wide trend, I'll get some more. I also got this pair of like pea green, seafoam green, high-waisted Wranglers, and I haven't actually tried these on yet. I think they will probably end up being too big for me, but I thought that they would be good to resell on either my Poshmark or my Etsy shop. So yeah, good find, they're in great condition. And I got this dress, which I'm really hoping fits me. It's sized a lot bigger than what my typical size is, but it's vintage, so it probably runs small. But it's this gorgeous like 90s Coldwater Creek dress. These are so in right now. It's a beautiful pattern. I think it would look great belted as well. So I got this dress. And then the last clothing item I got is this really, really comfy vintage sweater. It's a gorgeous blue color. I recently picked up like a more lavender colored, very similar sweater to this from a different thrift store, and I literally wear it like once a week. It's so comfortable. So I got another one. I love it. This will definitely be oversized on me, but I'm totally okay with that. And then I did get a few items, none of them for my gallery wall, but I got a couple of these like Christmas tins. I think for a lot of my friends, what I'll end up doing is making like peppermint bark this year or some other like smaller cookies and giving them to them in these like little tins. So I've been collecting them. I have like 5 or 6 now. Last but not least from Goodwill, I got these candle holders. I actually don't have anywhere to put these in my current house, but we will move eventually. We're not gonna be in this house for more than probably like another 3 to 5 years. And I just thought these were too awesome to pass up. I love brass, and I think one day these will look really great in my house. And then the last store that we went to on that first day, the fourth store overall, was this kind of like little boutique shop that's actually run by one of our friends. And she sells a mix of like new items, but also some antique items and also some items that she makes herself. I actually already have 2 pieces of artwork from her. I'll kind of put them on the screen now so you can see. She has like a real funky style. I love it. And I've been wanting to go back and get another piece from her. I did get this item. This is handmade by our friend, her name's Suzanne, and I'll have her business linked down below. I'll have all the places linked down below that I went to actually, but she made this piece herself and I'm really excited to add this to the gallery wall. And then I also got this print from her shop. I believe it's an antique and it's not made by her, but I do believe that this is an antique piece just based on the frame. And then I got this little clock, which will be the last thing I add to the gallery wall. I'll show you now how I plan on doing the gallery wall. Like I said, we don't have the brick wall actually finished or started yet, but now I have everything. I need to go on it so you can kind of see what my intention is. This is not antique, it just kind of has that antique look, but I wanted to add like a circular shape to that gallery wall. And they had a lot of like funny magnets, which I did put a clip of earlier in the video, and I was kind of laughing at one of them, and the worker that was there kindly gave me one for free, And I won't say what it says, but I will show you. I think it's just hilarious for anyone that is kind of snooping on your fridge. All right, so then the next day, my mom and dad and I actually drove about an hour away to a town called Bucyrus, Ohio, just a real small town. They have a really cool market. They sell all kinds of antique things. It's kind of like a nicer version of the antique mall that my mom and I had gone to the day before. So I did end up getting a couple things, even though I said I wasn't going to. I just couldn't pass some of these things up. So I got this little, it's kind of like a dog dressed as a reindeer little piece. And I just had to get this because it looks a lot like my dog Gibby. I just thought it was the cutest thing. And I knew that I needed a few more Christmas decorations this year. So yeah, I got it. Guys, how could I pass that up? And then I also ended up picking up their salsa. My husband Ryan and I had been there before and we got this salsa and it was so good. So I had to get it. It was really reasonably priced. But yeah, just some salsa, a weird addition to this haul. And then my dad actually very kindly bought me this hat. He said he would buy me something, so I got this hat. So now I have my brown hat and my black hat, and the collection is basically complete. And then, just when we thought we were finished with all the shopping, we ended up stumbling upon a Six shop, which we thought was a restaurant, and then we went in, and it was like another kind of boutique-y place where they had like candles and signs and everything. They were having very good deals, so I ended up getting two more things. I got this little, what do they call these? Weather vanes, like a weather vane type piece. And I got this like greenery to put around the bottom. And I figured this would be like a nice thing to put on our kitchen table during the winter season. So that was everything I got. It was a lot, I know, but like I said, everything does have a purpose. I don't need to do any more like shopping for Christmas decorations, I don't think. I'm excited to show you my decorate for Christmas. That'll be day one of Vlogmas. I am doing Vlogmas. I'll be vlogging every single day from December 1st through December 25th. So be sure to be on the lookout for that and make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. But thanks so much for watching, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this video. And be sure to let me know down in the comments if you've been to any of these places. And let me know which was your favorite purchase that I got. Thanks again for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!